So do you remember that show, Are You Smarter Than a Fifth Grader? Well, today you're going to get to see if you are smarter than a fifth grader. We are going to review order of operations and see how they apply to units. And I bet you're going to find out something new today, because I sure did when I looked into this. We are going to review order of operations. We are going to cover best practices for writing units, some which you may or may not know, and then highlight some of the common mistakes that you might be making. So order of operations, remember PEMDAS, each of those letters stand for something, and that is the order of which you must do the mathematical operations. So let's just jump right in. Why don't you grab a piece of paper and see if you can solve these problems? Pause the video if you need to. So in the first case, parentheses comes first. That's going to turn it into then a division problem. And then finally, you're going to multiply those together. In the second problem, again, we're going to take the division and multiplication first. They're going to take priority. And then finally, we'll add on the addition at the end, getting us a slightly different answer. In the final case, we jump all the way to the parentheses first because they have priority. And then we'll do the division next, and finally we'll add it up. So notice by just moving or removing the parentheses, we end up with three very different answers from the same mathematical numbers. Don't forget that multiplication and division are evaluated from left to right in the order you encounter them. Multiplication does not take precedent. This is going to come up a lot. So whenever you have the opportunity to just slap stuff in a numerator and a denominator, you're probably better off if you have the luxury of space. So let's check out the scenario that I ran into that I thought was confusing. We're going to be using the equation for Q here. If you've never seen this equation before, don't worry about it. We're really just looking at this in order of PEMDAS. And so what we're going to do is solve for C sub P, that's specific heat. And we're going to get the equation of heat over mass times change in temperature. Now, what I always like to do is plug in units to make sure that I did the math correctly. And we could write this linearly as either one of these. Notice that when you write it linearly, it is a bit more confusing. But let's go ahead and plug in some units here. You'll see that in all three scenarios, we really are ending up with the same expression. And you can always check that by just replacing units with numbers and seeing that in all three scenarios, we do still get the number one. But here's the deal. That expression on the end is technically wrong. And I always wondered why that was the incorrect way to write that. In fact, just to rub salt in the wound, the typical expression that you see is actually J divided by G times C. Notice that that is very different. In fact, if you plugged in numbers, you would get a different answer. Why is it that sometimes units seem to break order of operations? Well, maybe this isn't a surprise to you, but it was to me. Units are not numbers. And that does have an effect on stuff. So again, we know that numbers are governed by mathematical rules and the order of operations. But units are actually different. Units are representing the physical dimensions and have conventions that really prioritize clarity and consistency over a strict mathematical interpretation. So you can imagine that they have similar but slightly different rule sets. So I went ahead and looked at a couple style guides from scientific organizations online. I will share the links to them in the doobly-doo below, but here's the summary of what I found. So for multiplication, you'll want to use a half-high dot, sometimes called a center dot, or leave a space between the units. For example, meter seconds should have that space between them or that half high dot. You are not to use X for multiplication anymore for units. That's a big no-no. That might be confused as another unit. I would avoid using the space. If it looks like MS, that might be confused as milliseconds. In my opinion, half high dots are great. Otherwise, look for the space between the units. In the case of division, and again, I learned something new here, you should only have one solidus per unit expression. And solidus is another name for the division slash. I did not know that. Remember that when you're dealing with units, if you have a fraction, all the units are either going to be on the top or the bottom. If you reorganize your units, then you can set it up so there's only one solidus. Do we need it that way? I don't know, but that's the way the rules are. So you can also express units in the denominator with a negative exponent. I think many kids at the high school level would find this very uncomfortable, but you do see this a lot more in advanced literature. So give it a swing sometimes. Multiple factors are where unit notation rules do get interesting. Multiplication takes precedence over division unless otherwise noted. So this is breaking order of operation rules. Everything after the solidus is in the denominator. Joules divided by gram degree seconds, the way that should have been interpreted, grams and degrees Celsius multiplied together, even if there aren't parentheses there. That was the big thing I learned from this. Let me know in the comments. Am I the only one who didn't understand this already? That units don't always follow order of operations? I honestly didn't know that. It was one of those things that you just look up and you're like, man, why is this book getting these units wrong? And anytime you're like, why is this book getting the units wrong? That's probably on you. It's probably not the book that's wrong. So a little humility is always called for when you deal with things that you don't understand. You can obviously use parentheses to clarify grouping. I don't think they can stop you. So I would rather see it written as the grams times degrees Celsius together in parentheses, but you don't have to. And so you should not expect to see those parentheses all the time with units. Remember, when you have the luxury of space, fractional notation takes care of all this stuff. And if you're writing this out on paper, you definitely have enough room. So let's try a couple problems out. Let's see if you learned anything. Go ahead and pause the video. Okay, welcome back. Let's see if you identified the incorrect unit notations and then corrected them. The first one is fine. We've got half high dots and we've got negative exponents. Perfect. The second one is a problem. We have multiple solidi. Now you could rewrite this several ways. I think every single one of these are legit ways to rewrite this. And I would obviously recommend the fractional notation if you have the space. The next one, we've got half high dots. We've got solidi. We've got parentheses. Great job. In the next one, we want to avoid the X. We don't use that anymore to separate units. And then finally, in the last one, those are smashed together. Let them breathe. Let them breathe a little bit. Either put that space or, as again, as I highly recommend, half high dots. What did we learn? Mathematical expressions obviously follow order of operations. Hopefully that was a nice little review. Units usually do, but there are some striking exceptions that you want to keep an eye out for, or you might get confused. Don't think of units as breaking the rules. Think of them having their own separate rules. Effort you spend to reduce ambiguity in units is always going to pay off. So keep that in mind. What I learned today is that taking a little bit of time to be more thoughtful for units is always going to pay off, either for yourself or for somebody reading your work. And also paying attention to order of operations is always a good thing. I really appreciate you spending some time with me today. Thanks for watching. Have a great day.